first thing that pops into my head when I hear the word science is chemistry. What do you consider the most important use of science? To learn new things. What do you consider the greatest failure of science? I think the Big Bang Theory is the biggest fail theory of all time.
Okay. What is the first thing that pops into your head when you hear the word science? Bill Nye. What do you consider the most important use of science? Any way that we can make life better through science is like a go. It's a yes. So like medical science, exercise science that's healthy. So any way that we can make ourselves better. What do you consider the greatest failure of science? Ooh. The first thing that popped into my head was like NASA. Like they're a multi-billion dollar company that doesn't really do much other than, you know, 20 years ago when they finally got to the moon.
What is the first thing?
Questions. First thing that pops into your head when you hear the word science.
Science. Like
how bad I was at it in high school.
I think of physics. Because I'm really good at physics.
I'm really bad at physics.
I love physics. What do you consider the most important use of science to just make human life easier?
I would say probably like medical purposes, like cancer research and stuff.
That's a really good, see, that's making human life better.
Yes, yeah, okay.
Great minds.
Exactly. What do you consider the greatest failure of science?
Greatest. When people started changing their genders, that was a total and complete failure.
Is that science?
Of brain matter.
I don't think that's science.
They claim it as science. So I'm going to say that.
Greatest. I know one is really fun because it's to the Can Can song. Don't ask me why I know that, but I do. ASAP Science, y'all. Look it up. What do you consider the most important use of science to better the world? So to help the earth kind of help itself and then save species, not necessarily like Jurassic Park style, but like help pandas not become extinct, help the extinct list become shorter and let their populations grow. And just kind of like for the betterment of humanity, not necessarily like nuclear weapons sort of science kind of thing. What do you think consider the greatest failure of science? Honestly, probably the atomic bomb.
First thing that popped into my head with science is honestly just my studies. Being a chemical engineer, it's going to be very chemistry specific in the things that I'm going to be doing to edit or to create the things that I want to. Most important use of science, again relying on chemical engineering, it's honestly just the things that we do to make our lives easier. And that's, if you look really closely all around, you will find things that were the work of scientists and engineers. Literally everything. Greatest failure of science? I wouldn't say there is a failure of science. I'd say there's the misuse of what we learned from it. Quick example, nuclear technology. Yes, nuclear bombs, but that's only in the hands of those who are willing to use that toward that power. When in all reality, nuclear energy is the potential to be an unlimited source. So it's more about how you use it than exactly what it is.
Science. I love it. So I'm a physics major. So I study science all day, every day. It's kind of my thing.
Yeah.
I don't know what you actually want me to say about it. Something about science or just what comes to my head?
What comes to your head?
What comes to my head, I'm stoked. That's kind of what I do when I'm not here dancing or hanging out with people. I tend to go and study science stuff. I'm a nerd. What do you consider the most important use of science? Everything. Literally everything we do uses science. I tend to be on the side of wanting to study theoretical physics, which maybe not as applicable to everyday use. But like the phone that you're using to record me, made by science. The building that we're dancing in, made by science. I think science is useful for everything. Why do you consider the What do you consider the greatest failure of science? Greatest failure of science? Once upon a time, Albert Einstein came up with an equation called the, remember what it was called, the universal
theory of relativity.
No.
I was like, are you kidding?
That is not a failure.
No, okay, I was worried about you.
He came up with an equation that he called the universal constant, something like that. Basically, it was to try and explain a lot of things because he was trying to explain it without the universe expanding. And then we realized that the universe is expanding, and his equation was basically worthless. But that happens. We come up with models, we test them, we figure out things that are wrong with them, and we move on to better models. So he had an incomplete model, and he made some cool math with it, and then we were able to explain that away. So maybe that. I don't know. I don't think of anything as being a failure in science. It's always a shortcoming as we're getting to a new place, right?
Do you think science supports religion? Yes. My religious beliefs come from the LDS Church. If you think science supports religion, what do you consider most significant scientific proofs of religion? I think the most scientific proof of religion is that there are too many variables in this world to consider for everything to work out as perfectly as it does.
It supports religion? I think it does in a lot of cases. The only time it doesn't is where there's like a theory involved and they don't really know what's going on. If you think science supports religion, what do you consider the most significant scientific proof of religion? Scientific proof of religion? Like, in what way? Like, of God? So how does science prove God? I think there's a lot of things that we don't know as humans that we try to explain. Like how the universe was created. A lot of people think it was a Big Bang. But honestly, like, if I bought a model plane from a store and I shook it for millions of years, it would never build itself. So I think there was a mastermind behind that.
Do you think science supports religion? Absolutely.
Absolutely. I think they go hand in hand.
There's a scripture in a book that I study, and it says all things denote that there is a God. So I believe that everything, science included, proves that there is a God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
What are your religious beliefs?
We are both returned missionaries for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
That one. We're both very active in our church and everything. Do you think science supports religion?
What do you think consider the most significant scientific proof of religion?
Scientific proof of religion?
The way that life functions. I mean, if you look at how everything works in its perfect order, like how we're able to create life the way that we are, it's impossible for me to not see that as a divine act.
So for me, a big question that we always come back to is there a God? That's very attached to religion. And can you prove that there's a God with science? I think that you can. There's a lot of holes in science. There's a lot of things we don't understand. There's a lot of things we don't know. A lot of things that we just kind of make up ideas that can work for us and that we can understand, like the Big Bang Theory. That's not 100% proven. But what we can say is that God created the universe. And so
how I kind of mix that in is I can kind of see how there could have been a Big Bang and God caused the Big Bang.
Exactly.
He used that as a tool in order to create matter.
If we look at science, everything has a cause and effect. There has to be an ultimate cause, and God is that cause. And he affects everything. All right.
Do you think science supports religion? It depends on your viewpoint of how science and religion go hand in hand. We don't necessarily know our religion's timeline on our greater power's timeline, so it can be very different to our human mindset. And since time is a human construction, it doesn't even follow that. So, like, I'm referring that for the evolution and whatnot. That's the first thing that popped into my head. So there's that. I'm actually on a different religious path right now. I'm not even Christian anymore, but I still think that science is put on Earth to help us understand the Earth and help each other and help the Earth itself.
So you're more spiritual than religious?
Correct.
Gotcha.
Yes. If science supports religion, what do you consider the most scientific proofs of religion? Honestly, I don't know. But then again, I just came off of 8 hours at work.
Science supports religion. If you look closely, there is way too much to do. There are way too many things that happen in a particular order than you would expect normally to, because the world was created with order. Most specific proof? The element of science that most specifically proves or supports my religion would simply be creation of the universe. Second law of thermodynamics, all things naturally increase in entropy, they increase in the number of microstates they exist. And in order for that to have happened, there would have been a remarkable increase in the order for that to begin, and that happened when God created the universe. He put everything in order.
Do you think science supports religion? 100%. Does it support religion? Not necessarily. How long do you want me to go on about this? Because I could go on about this subject for a long time.
Go on.
Okay. Here's the deal. It depends on how you define religion. There's a lot of ways you can define religion. If religion is... how would you define religion, Ethan? What's the definition for this?
I guess, I'm talking about specifically proof of a God.
Proof of God. Well, yes. Then yes, definitely. I would say, though, there's several different ways of looking at things. What we're trying to find in this world is truth. We want to know what's truth, right? And so one of the original ways of finding truth is, as far as I believe, is that God came down and showed us and said, hey, this is the purpose of life. This is why we're here. This is what I want you to do with your time. And he kind of showed us the purpose of life. And that's, in my opinion, kind of the purpose of religion, is it shows us the purpose of life and it gives us God's view of the world. There's another way of looking at truth, though, and that's through observation. For instance, we can look at my sweatshirt and say it's gray, right? That wasn't revealed in some religious text. It wasn't brought down by a prophet. Nobody came and told me that my shirt is gray. I can intuitively look at my shirt and recognize that it's gray, just like the sidewalk is gray. And I can say that they're the same color through intuitive thinking and reasoning. And so we can find truth through other ways that aren't religion. And that is what science is. Science is looking at things, trying to understand them, and learning about them. And so I think religion and science is basically just two different ways to look at the same thing. They're both looking at truth, trying to teach us truth for different purposes. One is just man's curiosity, and one is God trying to show us what he wants us to do with our lives. But I 100% think that they support each other.